Okay, Virgo. This is a general reading for the sign of Virgo. If you have Virgo anywhere in your birth chart, this is your reading. It is a general reading, so take what resonates and leave the rest. You know what is for you and what is not for you. Thank you, Spirit. Messages for the sign of Virgo. Virgo, the Chinese New Year's begins. The Chinese New Year begins February 10th, and this will bring in the year of the Wood Dragon. This year's energy will be one that will guide us towards growth and towards progress and abundance. Thank you, Spirit. Messages for the sign of Taurus. Taurus, the Chinese New Year, the celebration usually lasts on average about 8 days. During the New Year celebration, there are several taboos that are recommended to be avoided. And avoiding these activities helps bring in or helps set the pace for the rest of the year. One of the more common taboos is to stay away from negative words. Words that may include are words like death, sickness, empty, pain, break, or kill are words that really have a negative energy attached to them. And by avoiding these negative words during the first week or during the celebration of the new year, it really does help make room for bringing the positive energy in and setting the pace for the rest of the year. And before we continue with your reading, let's look at our ESP cards. If this is your first time tuning in, what we've been doing is we've been practicing connecting with or using our intuition using these ESP cards. We've just been doing a quick little shuffle, and then I select one of these cards and we'll look at that card, and I'll send the image of the card to you. If at any time during this reading you believe you know what this card is, do write it in the comment box. If not, and then at the end of the reading, we'll see if we were able to connect intuitively. Thank you, Spirit. Messages for the sign of Taurus. And Taurus, we start off with the Five of Pentacles. The feeling of a missed opportunity, or not wanting to miss an opportunity for a partnership, for a connectedness, for a working relationship. In the past, you've felt taken advantage of, or you're afraid, or you thought that there was a missed opportunity. And that is followed by the legacy wealth, the a missed opportunity for finances, or you don't want to miss a financial opportunity. The foundation, the basis of this reading is the Seven of Swords. Thinking, working out, having a plan, and it's followed by the Queen of Wands. Trusting your intuition, being able to speak up, being able to sell yourself, not being able to speak or to ask for what it is that you would like or not sharing your thoughts and your ideas in fear that it will not be well received, or in fear that you may come across as being a braggart, or that you'll come across as being boastful. And Taurus, it is okay to talk yourself up. And you know, Taurus, it is not bragging when you are speaking the truth and you are speaking from a place of facts, and that you know, you're speaking up for yourself modestly. And at this time, you are being asked or being guided to share your goals and your ideas. And stepping out of your comfort zone. The universe, source, is bringing people into your life that are going to require or that need to have you share your goals, your ideas with them. Breaking free, breaking out of that shell of not being able to or not wanting to share the things that we have done, the things that we are capable of with others, and sharing our goals and our ideas with others has been hindering you, has been holding you back. But by breaking free, by breaking out of that and sharing your accomplishments, sharing your capabilities, and sharing your goals with others are going to be well received. There's people that the universe, or situations that the universe is bringing in for you, that will support your goals and your ambitions. But it is being required of you that you share and that you open up to that. And then here we see you looking towards, yes, looking towards the future. The King of Pentacles, the wealthiest card in the deck. The spiritual and emotional fulfillment. And the celebration for you, Taurus, this year of the Wood Dragon is going to bring in the energy of transformation for you. And it is going to require you to be open and to be ready for the spiritual development that is going to be surround the energy, that spiritual development, the energy of spiritual development is going to be surrounding you this year and encouraging you to have faith in yourself and to demonstrate your feelings towards your loved ones. And so the more trust that, and the more faith that we have in ourselves, the more we're able to demonstrate our feelings and our thoughts and our emotions towards those that are closest to us. Contracts agreements, an inheritance, the ending of pain and suffering, and the finding balance. And this year for you, Taurus, it's going to be about the finding balance between the physical and the spiritual, between the seen and the unseen. Change is part of life. And the more that we resist change, the more unhappy we become. Meaningful changes come from within. And we can start that by, we can start that change by using positive affirmations and practicing positive affirmations on a daily and sometimes even on an hourly basis. And before we conclude this reading, let's revisit this ESP card, this intuition card. And did you select the double X? If we were able to connect or you were able to tap into your intuition, I'm so glad that we were able to connect. If not, it's about the practice and it's about the learning how to connect that is important. Just because we do not succeed the first time does not mean that we will not succeed the next. And that is the message that I have for the sign of Taurus. Thank you, Taurus. You have a blessed week.